today. I'm going to replace the sun visors, which done that one, just got to do that one. I've also replaced the back of the seat bracket, like to thank Batty Bits for that. That was excellent. Got a little smelly as well there. That smells quite nice, bubble gum. What else did we do? We did some bits yesterday. Oh yeah, we've put, this is pretty cool. We got this from Just Campers, and you see a step down there. That's a step. Quite easy to fit. Mine was a bit harder because I had to drill it, but I don't believe you're supposed to. I think there's already holes there, but mine didn't have any. Obviously had some new jacking points put in at some point. I've got all the electrics out of the moment because I'm waiting for a stereo to put in there. I've got like the little fans up the top there. I'm going to wire that so that the cigarette lighter is permanently live, because it isn't at the moment. I've taken this rod out. This was used to be a curtain thing to go across the front window. I'm going to try and get something else to go across there. Yes, I think we're just cracking on with that at the moment. Hopefully. I think there's a few other bits. You can see down there. Clamp there. I have that on the window on there, on the window, on the steering. And on the other side. Not that I'm conscious about anybody nicking my van or anything, but there's a clamp on there as well. I had a lot of interest in the van, so I'll maybe just make sure it's safe, because they're not cheap and the money you put into them. Got a few other bits here to go on. There's a fog lamp in that, and little temperature gauge. All these are from Just Campers, and they get them out pretty quick to you. I'm waiting for a headlight from them, because one of my headlights is a bit crap actually. Yep, that's the oil temperature gauge dipstick. So you just put that in, connect two wires at the top, wire it all in at the clock, and done. So keeps that nice and cool. Keep checks. You can check to make sure that it's not running hot, shall I say. Or I'll put a new interior light in there as well. I'll actually see if I can put up there a link to the places I use, like Batty's Bits, down in Helsham, Just Campers over in Hampshire. I think it's Hampshire. And Heritage, because the indicator, not that side, the other side, stopped working the other day. So now we've got one from Heritage. It's not the same, but apparently it's adapt. You can adapt it. Give that a go. So we've now got a lot of our stuff packed away for our road trip, which is going to be into Dorset, then through Devon. So we're staying in Dorset for a few days, then we're going into Devon, I think, for one night. Yeah. Which will be Devon Cornwall, so it's just at the start of Cornwall, and then into the Land's End kind of way, tour around Cornwall, into Cheddar, into Wales, mid Wales up to Cardigan, and then trip all the way back. So about a round trip of about 1,000 miles, I think, just over, probably with a bit of touring, probably 1,500, maybe more. So we're just getting the van prepared for that. Done quite a lot. So we've got a new steering wheel. I'll show you that. So a new steering wheel and new horn, like the old Laurel and Hardy horns, that sort of era. You can see we've got a few things packed in here. So we've got a chemical toilet, we've got a shower that I will show you hooked up when we're away. I've added some more electrics down there. We've got the awning and stuff down there. We put the blackout blinds in to try them all out to make sure they're all fitting. They seem pretty good. These are all from Just Campers. We've got up here, because we're metal detectorists as well, we've managed to put a cargo net up there. We've got the metal detectors in there, so that keeps them out of the way. The back there, we've got the bed all rolled up, so we just roll it back out and it's done. I fixed the rock and roll bed because it wouldn't rock and roll properly, so that's done. These are all things that we didn't have sorted before when we first got the van. I've changed the oil, so it's done 500 miles on a new engine, and now we're back new oil, the right oil, and a couple of fans the wife put in there, and stereo. This thing here is an alarm, actually, if you believe it or not. It just stays on all the time, so it stays in your cigar lighter and it flashes blue. It is very loud when you forget to turn it off when you get in there. Quite a good idea, really, so you don't have to wire anything in. I've never had a problem with it. It's always been cool. So I can't think of anything else we've done. We've changed the headlight that was dodgy, was rusted basically, so it didn't have any, you know, didn't shine very well. Changed the bulbs to halogens, and I think you've already seen that. New gear, oh yeah, new gear knob, yeah, that was eBay. Then we've got, so the eyelids, so we put the eyelids on, new indicators, complete new indicators, because they were had it, they've been changed. So the eyelids, oh, we put a digital aerial in as well, for like the, this is a little digital aerial dab. Had to like run a wire, because it quite doesn't quite connect to the bodywork, just run a wire to it, extend it and screw it to the bodywork. But that's it, basically. Can't really think of anything else I've done. The step that I've done, that was put on. I decided I want to put the mirrors around that way. Give me more vision. Hopefully give me more so I can see more. Yeah, so that's it basically.